Who am I? A warrior who has faced several battles? An entity in red who's powerful and prideful? Do I spark fear? Or do I create pleasure? What do you see? Be my audience. Interpret my art. This is my art. Few days back, I was this. Someone called me a pharaoh. Someone called me a Persian saint in Tarsus. Someone called me a dark Neptune and also Queen Nefertiti. Few days back, I was this. Someone called me a burning heart, a spring flower. Someone just enjoyed the colors and the flamboyance of it all. This is my art. I am my art. I create art on my body, being my canvas, where I showcase different characters, which are abstract yet definitive. My name is Zeeshan Ali. I'm an artist, a stylist, a model, a photographer, a designer, a shapeshifter. The list can go on. But there was a time where I really didn't know what I wanted to do. 2012, I was really not aware of my passions and my career. Knowing what I really wanted to do was really, really important for me at that point of time. I was going through a time most of us go through. Where is my life heading? I really had no idea of who I wanted to be. There was a time where I sat down with a career counselor and went through the entire process of what I wanted to do. And that turned out to be fashion. When I realized I was into fashion, I wanted to break myself out of the box that I was living in. Tearing it apart and coming out of it, seeing what was available outside. And that's where I was introduced to avant-garde fashion. Researching on it through, I discovered different forms of fashion and different interpretations of fashion. Drag, club kids, and different sorts of other transformations and illusionists who use their body to showcase different characters and personalities. I was really inspired by all of this, and this is where I started trying out creative looks on myself, using whatever I had, be it myself, my costumes, my own wardrobe. This was the first look which I did, very first look that I had done. Though a little crunchy, there was nothing at that time in India who was teaching this kind of work in India. I had to practice on my own, being my own canvas, and YouTube was my teacher. And this was another look of mine, where it was completely inspired by colors. I started adding in headpieces and conceptualized costumes to it, which not only added to the look, but made it come alive in a way. This was inspired by a burning rose. And this was one of the ways I started diversifying my craft. I started playing around with different things. My major platform for showcasing my work was Instagram, through which I got a lot many collaborations. I was hooked on morphing myself into different characters. It can be based on real life. This was inspired by Farida Kahlo. Another one which was inspired by a white queen sort of a thing. It's based on imaginations as well. A kaval look, basically. And then another look, which was Celestia, the princess of the space. And I was going on creating more looks, be it myths and legends. This was based on a siren, basically. Another one, which was based on complete textures and architectures of it. Based on myths and legends, where I did unicorn. This was based on a Greek goddess, Alcalis, who is the goddess of misery and pain. I was transforming into colors, playing around with different colors and textures. This was completely made out of thermocol and paper, where I used different colors. This was another one where I tried out with patterns and splatters of colors. I was hooked on creating these kind of looks where inspirations were varied, being from a doormat. This look was inspired by a doormat, to artwork from other artists. Not only that, I was experimenting with different types of spaces and locations, I started experimenting with black lights and different locations. This was based on New Era, where I got to discuss about a new horizon and topics about where a woman wouldn't have to live in a space where she has to match up to other genders. And I collaborated with 101 India to create a documentary on my work, which plays on gender blurring characters. I got a chance to showcase two characters based on masculine and feminine energy, where I get to work with yin and yang, showcasing two sets of natures of humanity combined together. We shot in different locations, from studios to streets to my own house in Mumbai. It was a complete different experience, personally and professionally. I got to showcase my work to a louder, wider crowd. And doing that, everyone gave out a different emotion looking at my work. Some loved it, some were surprised by it, some hated it and were disgusted by it. I was really intrigued by these emotions, and I wanted to create work which stimulates different kinds of emotions in my viewer's mind. So I collaborated with a photographer to create a complete series based on Navrasa, as described by Natya Shastra, by Bharat Muni, where I got a chance to showcase 9 different characters based on Navrasa, where Nava means 9 and Rasa means emotion, and also the stimulation of emotion in a human mind. We created 9 looks, first starting with Sheer Shingharam, where the color is green and it signifies love. Next is Veeram. Color orange, confidence is what this rasa means. Next, Karuna, gray, sadness and sorrow. Adbhutam, surprise or wonder, by the color yellow. Hasyam, laughter, white. Bhayankaram, terror, black. Bibhatsam, blue. Shuki, it means disgusting, basically. And I try to incorporate with different kind of gelatin and that kind of a prosthetic makeup, which showcase very scaly and disgusting, grimy kind of a personality. The next one was Raudram, where I got to showcase anger. And the last, Shantam, tranquility, peace, which is referred by white or off-white. As you have seen, my work plays on gender roles. It blurs the gender. It has been an empowering process as an artist to be able to blur genders and stereotypes that have been already surviving in the society, and creating a space where I can be whoever I want to be. I can change the color of my skin from black, white, brown to green, yellow, and even orange. That was exhilarating. I can live my fantasy in my reality. Not only even that, I get to create and transform into different characters and personalities. Now I'm not my only canvas. I get to work on different other artists. And my collaboration has surged far and beyond, where I get a chance to work with different artists. For a recent shoot, I collaborated with Hita Chandrasekhar, where I got to transform her into a red goddess. Taking charge of her womanhood and talking about these things which are not being spoken as much, like menstruation. This picture basically talks about menstruation. My work was also featured in Femina magazine, where I got to discuss about how growing up and still having an inner child is important. I got the chance to speak in L, where I got to express how makeup is an expression, and how I get a chance to showcase my skills via my body. This is my work. This is how I have traveled from medical to fashion, making that big shift to create a persona for myself where I can grow as a person. I've not only gotten the chance to work through my art, it has been a way to nourish and encourage more skills and talents in me. It was also a way through which I discovered my personality and realized how I like being explorative and trying out different things. It was also a way where I got to discuss about androgyny, where masculine and feminine energies are merged together. My work has been a place where it has been a meal ticket and also a mode of expression. Throughout my entire journey, the only thing that has been constant and yet evolving, that has been me. I had to do more than 200 shoots in my own room, on different looks, on my own body, creating on my own costumes and transforming myself, using makeup and hair and everything, using my window as a light source and a cheap Android phone as my camera to click my pictures, so that I was able to, throughout this entire journey, that's what I get it from. I can be whoever I want to be. I don't need to wait on question on other people and follow the stereotype. I can create my fantasy. I can live my fantasy in my real life. And not only that, I get to work on other people and create art on other people. And that's what leaves me to the point to tell you, your body is also a canvas. You can create the life that you want to live too. Paint your body with the colors that you like, because you are who you want to be and not meant to be.